I've been a part of the My Life as a Teenage Robot fandom for over 4 years now. This channel has helped me learn a lot about the past of the community, all the way back to 2003 when the series premiered. I don't believe that anyone else has organized the generations of the community, so I made an unofficial My Life as a Teenage Robot fan generation chart. I shared it with the community on our Discord, and they seem to approve of it. Today, we'll take a look into it. Before we start, you should know that the generations are determined by when you first expressed your love for the show online. Just because you watched the show when you were in diapers doesn't make you a Generation 1 fan. Alright, let's get into this. The first generation of MLAATR fans dates all the way back to 2003 and extends all the way up until 2009. It should be relatively obvious why I chose these particular dates, as the show started in 2003 and aired its last episode in America in 2009. So anyone who was vocal about their love for the show online during the period where new episodes were airing are considered Generation 1. During this period, blogs were the most common place to talk about the show. The most notable blog at the time was the Teenage Roblog, which we've talked about in the past. Check out that video for more information about the Roblog. But for now, the Roblog is essentially an archived MLAATR fan page which was run by the creators of the show. Obviously, if you were a fan at this point, you're likely in your late 20s or older. Most of the information about the actual community at this point is becoming increasingly difficult to discover. But members like XJ0 and One Jenny Fan help keep it alive. Speaking of XJ0, we did an interview with him where he explained what the community was like at that point. The second generation is undoubtedly the dark ages of our community. This period goes from 2010 to 2014 and is defined by the lack of new content related to the show. While original characters like Chaos Jenny were born around this time, the former generation of fans typically moved on to new things. As blog websites were starting to die out, the Teenage Roblog was just about abandoned. This was also the generation where Zone released the infamous porn parody, What in the Robot. Some of the people who watched the parody became infatuated with the show, bringing some new life into the community. Aside from the parody, most of the new video-related content based on MLAATR were AMVs, some of which remain the most viewed Teenage Robot videos to date. Despite this, the community was scattered across the internet, with no real place to congregate. Sure, there were Facebook groups like Official MLAATR Fan Page, which Robin Zetti himself was involved with, but fans were still separated for the most part. Things seemed hopeless, but somewhere in America, a young man named Nathan Altenburn had an idea. This brings us into the third generation. This generation lasted from 2014 to 2017 and was sparked by the announcement of My Life as a Teenage Robot Rebooted. We've explained the significance of this announcement before, but it can't be understated. It wasn't common to see someone attempt to bring back a show and get the blessing of the original creator of said show. My Life as a Teenage Robot Rebooted was a huge deal to the community. A bunch of dedicated fans applied to be a part of it, and some first-generation fans took a second look at the community and decided to return to it in anticipation of future episodes. On top of that, this period had popular YouTubers such as Rebel Taxi, Channel Frederator, and make videos praising the show, bringing even more fans to the community. The community started to rise back to its former glory. I hate to shoehorn myself into this video, but I think that the fan base has a place in this video. I created the My Life as a Teenage Robot fanbase on Facebook after watching the majority of the show back in 2015. I attempted to combine all of the existing Teenage Robot groups on Facebook and succeeded for the most part. My goal in the community was to bring all the fans together in one place. This channel was created on August 1st, 2016, and I've been trying to keep fans of the show entertained with new videos ever since. In 2017, after a bout of drama with the community, I decided to leave the channel temporarily. Later on in that year, another MLAATR channel, the official Jenny Wakeman, decided to leave too, but she never came back. While Rebooted was still in progress, the community was becoming restless and was once again looking for content. Some found it in the amazing artwork from other fans of the show, while others found it in creating their own project, like Steeplord's MLAATR 8-bit. This brings us into the final generation of our fandom. Well, so far at least. This generation started in 2018 and is still continuing. During this generation, we saw a surge in fans. The fanbase YouTube channel returned, arms swinging. The goal was to make weekly content for fans of the show. This brought the channel from 970 subscribers to over 7,000 today. On top of that, there were now Discord groups for both My Life as a Teenage Robot Rebooted and the My Life as a Teenage Robot fanbase. While they both existed before this generation, they exploded in popularity during this generation. But why now? While it has been argued that the return of the fanbase is what sparked more interest in the show, I don't believe that's what caused it. Around this time, a silhouette image of the new Steven Universe villain Spinel was revealed. A bunch of people noticed that she looked like Jenny, and Reddit exploded. I personally believe that a lot of the new fans who emerged at this point discovered the show after seeing the comparisons between the characters. Regardless, the amount of people who were a part of this community at this point were unprecedented. I haven't seen any
evidence
that it was more active, even when the show was still airing. Rebooted still continues to reveal information regarding their project in live streams, and is still widely supported by the community. Thanks to Pencil Juice and an overwhelming number of animator fans, My Life as a Teenage Robot Reanimated is coming up fast and will premiere on this channel in the near future. Aside from that, artists like Plants10000 are creating comics related to My Life as a Teenage Robot, and Travok has been extending the frames of the first episode of My Life as a Teenage Robot to be 16:9 instead of the 4:3 we've got. Not by stretching out the image, but by actually adding to the frame. Like, who does that? The community has been awesome lately, and I can only see us growing stronger past this point. The fourth generation of the fandom won't be the final generation. There's going to be more stuff happening in the future to warrant a fifth generation, and so on. It's up to the fans to decide what direction it goes in. So, when did you start? What generation are you from? Be sure to tell us in the comments below. Oh, and remember how I mentioned how I wanted to bring the community together in one place? Well, we succeeded on our Discord server. We're over 1,000 members strong, and we're almost always active. The link to join is in the description below. I've been your narrator, Andre. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, leave a rating. If you want to reach us, leave a comment. Or check out our other platforms. Links are in the description.
Who makes this? Why did they make this? Like, come on, man. Like, come on, just look at it. Look at it.